Papa, we pray. Dear Heavenly Father, God, in Jesus' name, we come before you.
亲爱的阿爸父，我们来到你的面前。
I just ask that you please, Lord, help us to really connect with you today.
请你帮助我们今天可以与你相连。
Father, God, help us to focus on you.
帮助我们能够专注在你的身上。
And think about you.
思想你。
Lead us by your Holy Spirit.
求你圣灵来带领我们。
And Father God, I just ask that you please speak through me unto all of us.
我求阿爸父，你通过我能够向众人讲话。
Give us your thoughts.
将你的想法给我们。
And give us your word.
将你的话语给我们。
Set us free from all the worldly oppression.
释放我们脱离这个世界一切的这些压力。
I just ask that you please, the Lord, cover us with the blood of Jesus, forgive us of all our sins.
求主耶稣的宝血来遮盖我们，来赦免我们的罪。
As we also forgive those who sinned against us.
我们也赦免那些得罪我们的人。
I just ask that you please restore us to you.
求你来修复我们。
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
奉耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
Amen.
Today I want to talk to you about the connection with God.
今天想要讲到跟神的连接。
We are supposed to originally.From the beginning, we were supposed to be connected with God, as Adam was.
我们本应该是与神相连的，就像亚当那个时候一样。
Adam walked with God.
亚当与神同行。
And there was communication between them.
他跟神之间是有联系的，有交流的。
When God made man and woman on the earth,
当神创造男人和女人在这个世上的时候
，God visited them every cool of the day.
神每次在凉风吹起的时候，他就会去拜访他们。
And they talked to each other.
他们彼此的交流。
And Adam was a son of God. He was a son to God.
亚当是神的儿子，像一个儿子一样对他来说。
And also, Eve was a daughter of God.
夏娃是神的女儿。
But there was a thing that happened. The devil came and separated the relationship between man and God.
但是撒旦却进来拆散了我们跟神之间的关系。
The devil has deceived us.
撒旦蒙蔽了我们。
To commit sin.
让我们去犯罪。
Which is disobedience unto God's perfect commandment.
这个罪就是去违背了神的诫命。
And therefore it was separated.
以至于人跟神就分开了。
And since then, man has always been striving to enter into a communication with God.
接下来的整个人类一直在努力的想要去修复跟神之间的关系。
You know, Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden was a very happy, peaceful, perfect world with God.
当亚当和夏娃在伊甸园的时候，他们是非常快乐、非常幸福的，是一个完美的一个生活状态。
When they were separated,
当他们与神隔绝以后
，then started all the curses in the world.
然后整个世上的咒诅也都起来了。
Bible records that the trees start bearing thorns.
圣经上描述说，这个树也这个树里面开始长荆棘。
And then the world was turning into more a violent, violent, bloodthirsty world.
整个世界也变得越来越暴力，越来越血腥。
I believe the animals were even only given the food to eat for plants and trees, and then they changed.
我也相信在起初的时候 连肉食动物他们原本也是吃草的而现在他们的本性都被改变了
Mosquitoes weren't supposed to bite us and drink our blood
我想蚊子也不应该吸我们的血
They might be eating flowers and trees and whatever other things originally purpose
起初的这个创造这些动物可能他们只是吃外面的草
But something happened that
没事你过去
Nature even changedIt's form from being good to being violent and selfish and evil.
但是一些事情发生，导致整个自然界都开始转变的，变得越来越血腥，越来越暴力，越来越自私。
We are supposed to be perfect in its beauty, and we are also be supposed to be perfect with wisdom and knowledge, and everything was supposed to be very beautiful with God.
我们本来是非常完美的，在我们的形象，在我们的智慧、知识上面，都是和神是有神的这个形象的，非常完美的。
And when you're again together with God, there is this unity and perfectness going to re-uprise again in your life.
而如今当我们在跟神重新连接的时候，神的这个形象，他的荣美，他的知识智慧，又能够重新的在我们心中修复出来。
You may have a lot of problems, a lot of things that's going on in your mind.
可能你现在脑子里面或者生活当中有很多的问题，困难。
But as you have unity with God, it all gets restored.
但是当你跟神修复这个关系的时候，这些神所原来应许的都会重新修复在你的生命当中。
But what is the problem?
但是问题是什么？
The devil constantly tries to steal our mind off of God.
是撒旦一直在努力的想把我们的思想从神那边夺走。
He'll offer you all the lusts of the world, all the things of the world.
他会给你提供这个世上所有一切的这些享乐的这些东西。
If he can take your eyes off of God and put your eyes on those things.
只要他能够把你的眼睛脱离这个神，放到这些世界上的享乐的东西。
And as your eyes are off of God.
当我们的眼睛开始不再定睛于神的时候。
Then comes all these curses and all these problems in your life.
那你生命当中就开始出现咒诅，出现问题。
If your eyes are continually on Jesus strongly.
如果你的眼目一直的定睛在耶稣的身上。
The devil cannot even touch you.
魔鬼甚至都没有办法触碰你。
But if you're in rebellion against him, doing the will of the devil, lusting after the world.
但是如果你是在一个悖逆的一个状态，做撒旦要你做的事情，去贪恋这个世界。
Then your life can get destroyed.
那你的生命就一定会被毁灭。
Doesn't matter you confess Jesus is Christ. Doesn't matter.
不管你嘴上承不承认耶稣是你的主都没有关系。
As you read today.
我们今天读到的。
The last verse in Ephesians, right?Colossians chapter 3 in the verse
in, 我们今天宣告的那一节经文哥罗西书
the last verse and he will repay God will repay the evil right
那句话的那个后面一句话说神会审判、恶人
all the bad behaviors of mankind anybody including Christians
指的是所有的人包括那些嘴上说是基督徒的那些人他说
Right, Colossians chapter 3.
哥罗西书第三章第二十五节，那行不义的必受不义的报应，主并不偏待人。
Yeah. He that doeth wrong will receive for the wrong which he had done. And there is no respect of person. That means it doesn't matter whether you believe or not, whether you're a son of God or daughter of God, it doesn't matter. You will be repaid for what you've done wrong. Understand?
他说那些行不义的就会遭受不义的报应不管你嘴上说、基督是主或者是怎么样那么、你的行为也会遭到神的审判
It's not that God hates you
不是神恨你
Okay, it's not that God hates you but God is a just God
神是一个公平的神
and wanting you to turn around and change from your evil ways to come back to the Lord
他盼望我们是远离我们的恶行转变过来
That's why as a form of punishment that is to draw the people near back to God in the right way.
有的神会在这个世上会降一些这个问题给我们，以致我们可以被改变，能够吸引他重新回到神面前。
We were driving in the road, and I was discussing with Jeremy that hey, the road, you know, in China they don't really keep the law, and then he said, well, the law was meant to what?
Break.
No, the law is meant to. Yeah, to improve people's awareness to keep the law and to be safe, right?
Oh, 他们在开车过来的路上 ，Alfred 在跟Jeremy 在讨论为什么中国人不遵守交通规则。然后Jeremy 就说，这个这个交通规则的这个目的是为了帮助人有这个守法的意识，让你能够知道什么是。
Yeah, the reason for law of God is also same.
而神的律法同样也是这样的。
He's trying to protect you.
是为了要保护我们。
From being destroyed.
让我们不至于被毁灭。
That's why he said, "Don't touch, don't handle," you know.
所以说不要做这个，不要做那个。
And lead you because he want to protect you, not because he want to punish you.
不是为了要惩罚我们，因为我们做了惩罚我们，而是为了提前告诉我们，这样就可以保护我们。
Punishment was not the reason why he made the law.
神创造律法不是要来惩罚。
It's because he loves you and he want to protect you.
是因为他爱我们，他要保护我们。
Hey, don't go jump off the cliff, you can die. Don't do it.
不要跳到悬崖下面去，因为你可能会死掉。
If a kid is crossing the road, you might, hey, don't cross the road. There's cars coming. It's dangerous.
如果有小孩要穿马路，你可能要一把抓住他，说你不要
穿。And if you keep on thinking that you might, hey, I told you don't do it, you might hit him, right?
如果这个小孩如果不听话，一直要想要去穿马路
just to get him understand.
那你可能会管教他，你可能会打他，让他明白。
The kid doesn't understand.
因为小孩可能不明白。
We don't understand why God said don't do this, but as you understand later, it was to protect you from getting hurt, getting harmed.
我们可能一开始不明白神为什么说不能做这个不能做那个，但是当我们慢慢成长起来，就会知道说他是为了保护我们，让我们不要受到伤害。
When I first came to God,
当我一开始来到神面前的时候
，God chastised me a lot.
神管教我很多很多。
Because many of my ways were worldly and evil.
因为很多时候我做事的方式是属世界的，并且是邪恶的。
Okay, I was pretty lustful.
我很贪恋这些世上的东西。
I was very evil in my thinking.
在我的想法里面有很多的邪恶。
And I like, you know, always dating, looking for girlfriends, like all the young people.
整天想的就是怎么样可以约会女孩子。
Right. And you know, always brought me to trouble and trouble.
啊，这些想法总是带我进入很多的问题。
And then I start getting led by the Lord. I start going to church, okay?
然后我就开始去教会，开始慢慢的被神带领。
But even while going to the church,
即使在我去教会的这些时间
，I was hanging out in clubs.
我还是去酒吧里面喝酒
，and then get bad girlfriends, okay?
然后会交一些错误的女朋友
，and doing sinful deeds.
然后做一些罪恶的行为
，while going to church, okay? While
同时我在去教会
，and then got one day have that ex-boyfriend show up for the girlfriend, and then he take her away, you know?
以至于后来我的女朋友的前男友突然出现，把我的女朋友就带走了。
Now I was angry at God.
所以我对神很生气的。
I was like, why you do this to me?
我说你为什么要对我做这样的事情
？I'm going to church now. Can't you see?
我现在不是去教会了吗
？Why would you do this to me?
你为什么要做这样的事情给我
？And then you know,
我是很生气的。
And I was even teaching her and evangelizing to the girl about God. You understand?
我当时还在给我的女朋友去传福音呢，还想跟她读圣经呢。
But of course, I was doing all kinds of evil things with her. That's why.
但是同时，我也和他做一些很多邪恶的事情。
And I loved her more than God.
而我爱他超过我爱神。
Do you understand? That was hindering my relationship with God.
啊，这个严重影响了我跟神之间的关系。
Now, as I was taken away,
而当那个女生被带走了以后
，God led me to this person with gift of healing and prophesying and speaking tongues. Okay.
后来神带领我认识了一个人，这个人他有很多的恩赐，他可以说方言、翻方言、医治赶鬼，很多的恩赐。
And I had a tuberculosis, and he healed me of that. You know,
我本来有个肺结核，他为我祷告的时候，我的肺结核就好了。
I was kind of surprised.
所以我当时很惊讶。
I was like, can God do this too?
我想，哇，神居然能做这样的事情。
I've heard from my old life, my parents and my you know, people.
我以前从我的父母的他们的教会听说。
That all those gifts stopped. Okay.
说这个这些恩赐啊都没有了。
But now I experienced it in real life.
然后我自己在生命当中，我经历了这样的事情。
I was like, wow, can God really do this?
我想神居然能做这样神奇的事情。
It excited me.
让我觉得很兴奋。
And it kind of led me, wow, is God this real? I mean, I know God is real, but I mean, this is like a little bit further than my thinking, okay?
我觉得神居然可以这么真实，虽然我知道神很真实，但是这个已经有点超出了我能想象的范围。
Back in the day, I just thought he was far, far away and not really, you know, caring too much of our interfering with our lives.
我原来觉得神是一个很遥远的神，他可能不是很在意要来干预我们的生活。
And therefore, because I believed that I really didn't really seek God.
因为我是这样想的，所以我也不太去寻求神。
And neither did I see that from my parents.
同时，我从我的基督徒的父母身上，我也看不到这样的生活。
And they didn't really have.Really hearing voice kind of connection with God, okay?
他们没有跟神的一个连接，他们也听不到神的声音。
But where I see this guy is like, oh, he has this kind of connection with God.
然后我看到这个人，这个人他有跟神的连接。
And I really got interested to know more. How is he doing this?
我当时就很感兴趣，我就想这个人他是怎么样获得跟神的连接。
Okay. Now this interest led me to find out the methods.
因为这样的一个兴趣引导我去寻找这个方法。
He said fast and praying and keeping yourself clean from the world.
那个人就说，他说你要禁食，要祷告，要保守你自己，不去沾染这个世界上的东西。
And then he said you can get it too.
他说你也可以得着的。
I was like really, I really wanted it.
然后我当时心里就非常想要。
So he said then fast every one day out of the week.
他就跟我说，那你一个礼拜禁食一天。
And If you can, turn off your cell phone, the worldly things, stop watching those things, and just read the Bible and talk to God.
如果可能的话，关掉你的手机，不要看这个世界上的东西，不要看一些乱七八糟的视频，就专心的祷告、读经、寻求神。
Now, that was a method, okay? This is a method of seeking God.
这只是一个方法。
And it can get you religious in this method.
这个方法可以可能会把你变得宗教化。
Many people use the method and become legalist.
很多人用方法使自己变得很宗教，很律法主义。
And in that way, lose a heart for God, lose a real connection with God.
以至于在这个过程当中，却丢失了和神的这个心。
And I've been putting a lot of method before. Like, oh, pray 2 hours a day at least, minimum.
我以前总是告诉你们一些方法，比如说要祷告，一天要祷告2个小时以上。
Read the word, memorize it.
读圣经，背诵经文。
When you pray, lift up your hands, use your mouth to pray.
当你祷告的时候，举起手，用你的嘴巴去祷告。
When you do things, I mean, you know, fast and pray, all these kind of things.
当有什么问题出来的时候，禁食祷告。
Now all those methods.Are a form of reaching God and having that connection with God.
啊，这些所有的方法，它都是一个形式，为的是让我们可以更加的遇见神，连接。
What is really important is
啊，真正重要的是
in the midst of that religious activity, are you really meeting God?
在这些活动、这些宗教的这些行为中间，你是不是真的遇见神了？
Maybe you're just doing things.Religiously,
如果你只是以一个宗教的心态去做这些事情
，but have no connection with God,
但是却没有跟神有这样的连接。
And God is telling us that is a waste of time.
而神说这样是在浪费时间。
If you're not trying to connect with God and you don't connect with God during the midst of that,
如果你没有想要去连接神，或者在这个过程当中你也没有连接到神
，of course your problems will be solved. Of course some things will get better.But you become a robot. You're becoming a robot.
可能在这个过程当中，你的问题解决了，你的祷告也应许了，但是你却没有真的就是连接到神的身上。
Do you guys understand what I'm telling you?
你明白我在说什么吗
？Okay, let's go to 约翰福音第二章。
约翰福音第二章
一节。
第一节，那你读。
第三人在加利利的迦拿有娶亲的筵席，耶稣的母亲在那里。耶稣和他的门徒也被请去赴席，酒用尽了。耶稣的母亲对他说：“他们没有酒了。”耶稣说：“母亲，我与你有什么相干？我的时候还没有到。”他母亲对人说：“他告诉你们什么，你们就做什么。照犹太人洁净的规矩，有六口石缸摆在那里，每口可以盛2-3桶水。”耶稣对佣人说：“把缸倒满了水。”他们就倒满了，直到缸口。耶稣又说：“现在可以，舀出来，送给管筵席的。”他们就送了去。管筵席的尝了那水变的酒，并不知道是哪里来的，只有舀水的佣人知道。管筵席的便叫新郎来，对他说：“人都是先摆上好酒。”等客喝足了才摆上吃的，你倒把好酒留到如今。
到十一节，
这是耶稣所行的头一件神迹，是在加利利的迦拿行的，显出他的荣耀来，他的门徒就信了他。
Okay, so here is the first miracle that Jesus did.
就是耶稣行的第一个神迹。
That Johann records.
约翰记录下来的第一个神迹。
Why is it so important? It comes out of the second chapter.
为什么这个神迹很重要？它第二章就开始讲到。
It is the first miracle that Jesus ever did when he was on earth. This is the first miracle that Jesus did.
这是耶稣在世上行的第一个神迹。
Now there's many ways to look at this.
这个故事有很多的角度可以看。
Now, even his mother has asked Jesus to change the water, I mean, to get some wine or something.
甚至他的妈妈也叫他说把这个去弄一点酒过来。
And we might see the mother's faith.
你可以看到他母亲的信心。
Jesus didn't really answer her.
耶稣没有直接的回答他。
Good.In verse 4, she said, Woman, whatever I have to do with you, mine hour is not yet come.
耶稣说，妇人，我与你有什么相干呢？我的时候还没有到。
Now, does it matter whether there was a problem or not? Mary asked Jesus, "Hey, they have no wine."
当他们遇见这个问题的时候，玛利亚就马上去找了耶稣，说有这样的一个问题。
In your life, you may run out of things.、Right?
在你的生命当中，你可能用尽了所有的方法。
You may have a lack of things.
你可能缺乏一些东西。
And somehow Mary had faith in Jesus.
然后玛利亚在这边对耶稣很有信心。
And even Jesus kind of said, "Hey, my hour not come. You know, I'm not going to do it." Kind of feeling.
耶稣虽然他的回答是有点拒绝的口吻，说我的时间还没有到。
The mother just said to the servant, "Hey, do whatever this guy says. Do whatever he says."
但是他母亲依旧对他的佣人说，就耶稣无论告诉你什么，你们就去做。
In here, you might see some faith, right?
你可以看到他母亲的信心。
And Jesus says, "I fill the water pots with water."
然后耶稣就对佣人说，把这些缸全部都盛满。
And then he said, "Just draw it out and give it to them."
把这个里面的水舀出来，给那个管宴席的人。
And then it turned into wine.
这个缸里的水就变成了酒。
Because they obeyed his voice.
因为他们顺服了他的旨意。
And it says in 11.
到十一节的时候，他讲到说。
This beginning of miracles did Jesus in Cana of Galilee and manifested forth his glory, and his disciples believed on him.
所以耶稣这是所行的第一个神迹，就是在加利利加拿行的，显出他的荣耀来，他的门徒就信他。
Now, solving the problem,
解决问题
was not the thing that was important to the disciples.
你知道解决问题本身对门徒来说不是最重要的。
To the people.It may be that, oh, we are out of wine, oh, we need some wine, oh, Jesus makes some wine, okay?
可能对那些参加宴席的客人来说，哦，我们没有酒了，耶稣变出酒来，我们就可以喝，问题就解决了。
That was not the problem.
但是这个不是重点。
That is important.
这不是最重要的。
When the disciples saw that thing,
是当他的门徒看到耶稣行了神迹以后，
then they believed.
他们相信了他。
That Jesus is the Messiah.
他们相信耶稣是弥赛亚。
It is, he is the right hand of God. He is God.
他是神。
Now, you have seen magic tricks before, right?
你们有看到过魔术，对吗？
Right? Some people make like a, you know, out of nothing, you know, they pull out a pigeon or something.
有的时候那个魔术师从什么都没有拉出一个，就拉出一个鸽子出来。
Or they just take out a coin out of people's ear, you know, those kind of thing, right?
拿个硬币就从你的后面变出来。
Oh, where did it come from?
说它是从哪边变出来的。
Now, we all know it's a trick, right?
我们知道这个魔术。
Nobody thinks that they can make money out of the ear like that, okay?
我们知道这只是一个魔术，没有一个人真的相信说有人可以从耳朵后面变出钱来。
We want to find out the trick. What's the trick behind it? What's the trick?
我们都喜欢去问说这个魔术背后是什么样的一个原理。
What is the trick behind this?
你是用什么手段把它变出来的
？Okay, when the disciples saw that water was turned into wine at the command of Jesus,
当他的门徒看到在耶稣的命令下这个水变成了酒
，they saw this created miracle of God.
他们看到的是神创造的一个神迹。
From water, that is H2O, into wine, into alcohol.
他看到的是一个从水 HRO 的这个 H2O 的这个水变成了酒精乙醇，还记得一点。
Okay.
对。
This kind of change.
这样的一个改变，物质的改变
，gave these people a hope.
给了这些门徒一个信心
，an excitement，
一个兴奋的点。
This is God，
这个人是神。
This is the Messiah that was promised，
这个是神应许的那个弥赛亚。
And we have finally met him，
我们终于遇见他了。
This excitement，
这样的一个兴奋
，was very very important to the disciples，
对门徒来说是非常重要的。
Because all this time，
因为这些年来
，in our lifetime。
在我们的生命当中
，We thought we were alone by ourselves.
我们一直以为我们是自己孤立存在的这个世界上。
Oh, we just came by ourselves.
我们自己来到这个世上。
And one day we're gonna die.
有一天我们要死掉。
Go alone.
然后孤单的死去。
But here's this hope.
但是盼望就在这里。
That God is real.
就是神是真的。
And you can meet God.
你可以遇见神。
And experience God.
经历神。
On earth.
在这个地球上就
right now,
现在就可以建立，在这个世界就可以建立。
To whoever sought the Lord,
对于那些寻求的人来说
，God will come to you.
神会来到你的面前。
This excitement,
这样的一个兴奋。
A being one with God again on this earth.
是能够在这个世上与神同在。
Should drive you to seek God.
这样的一个盼望应该促使我们去更多寻求神。
Of course, there are miracles, and do we not see miracles? We see miracles so much on the way.
当我们在寻求的过程当中，我们没有见过神迹吗？我们见太多的神迹，但这只是路上所经历。
But those miracles only confirm.
这些神迹只是向我们证明。
The wow.I'm experiencing God.
证明我在经历神。
I'm being connected to God.
我在与神相连。
I'm seeing God's work in front of my eyes.
我看到神的工作就在我眼前发生。
When I pray,
当我祷告
or when the answer comes,
神的应许来临的时候
God is hearing me.
我知道神听我的祷告。
It's not that the problem was so important.
不是说那个问题有多么重要。
You know, sometimes many people live with all those problems. They still live, right?
你知道很多人他有很多的问题，他们照样就这样苟且生存。
So whether it gets solved or not, it's not a huge difference actually.
所以问题解不解决，其实不是一个特别大的问题。
It might just take your stress off.
它可能就是让你更加有压力而已。
Oh, we don't have wine.
啊，我们没有酒。
Oh, and I pray and get us wine.
哦，然后祷告了就有酒了。
Big deal, okay?
有什么大不了的呢
？Drink water, okay? You can drink water and be sober, okay?
Okay, 没有酒了就喝水也可以啊。
Right?
清醒一点就喝水就好了。
Okay. Just drink water is okay too, right? But that is not important. It's that you really experiencing God in real life and meeting God in a real way.
所以问题的解决不是最重要的，而是我们通过这个问题的解决能够经历神。
That should be the excitement of us.
这个应该是我们那个兴奋的点。
Moses,
摩西
was a tired guy. Was a tired guy. He had a dream.
Tired guy.
Yeah, he was.
摩西他很疲惫。
He was tired.
他很累。
Of his life.
他对自己的生命也很疲惫。
He tried to do it on his own.
Moses?
Yeah, Moses.
然后他做了一个梦。
He had some kind of calling that he maybe feel like he know.
他觉得自己可能有一些呼召，但是他不是很确定。
And when he saw some Egyptian beating a Hebrew.
然后他看到有这个埃及人打这个希伯来人的时候。
He got filled with anger.
他非常的生气。
Filled with righteous anger.
充满了正义的怒火。
I should do something of it. I feel like I need to do something about it.
我觉得我要做一些事情来改变。
So what did he do?
他做了什么？
He killed a guy. He killed the Egyptian.
他就把那个埃及人杀掉了。
Okay. And then the next day,
第二天
he sees two Hebrew people fighting each other.
他看到两个希伯来人在打架。
And then he's like, hey, what are you guys doing, right?
他就去劝架，说你们不要打了，你们干嘛呢？
And then this guy said, what? Are you going to kill me too?
然后那个希伯来说：“干嘛？你想打？你现在把我杀死吗
？”He thought nobody saw it.
他以为没有人看见他杀了埃及人。
But actually, they know it.
但是大家都知道。
He's the one who killed the Egyptian.
大家都知道是摩西把那个埃及人杀的。
So with that fear, he ran away.
带着这样的恐惧，他逃跑。
He ran away from Egypt.
他跑出埃及了。
And in the wilderness, he's there for 40 years.
然后在旷野里面，他待了40年。
It's in a hard life. It's in a desert place.
在一个像沙漠一样的地方。
And he, you know, he's working for this Laban or something like that, right?
Father-in-law,
he gets wives and he has children. He's just living, you know.
然后他结了婚，他就为他的这个岳父在放羊。
Just a normal life, just chasing after, you know, maybe wealth and you know well-being.
他就开始做一个很普通人的一个生活，去追寻这个世上的财富。
Nothing important.
没有什么价值。
No real big dream.
没有什么大的梦想。
Okay, just wasting away, getting older and older. He's turning to 80.
然后变得越来越老，越来越老，最后变成80岁。
And he's turning to 80, and nothing going on in his life.
到了80岁，生命中间什么都没有发生。
Just looking to die.
就等着去死。
That's what I saw in this morning. Some guy, you know, in our English corner, sent us a you know thing about life. Okay.
Things about life.
Some cartoon about life.
所以今天早上在我今天早上我们祷告组里一个人他给我发了一个图画关于生命的图画。
In this 图画 it says, oh, you know, you're born as a baby.
他说在这个图画里面他说你出生是一个婴孩。
You grow up and you study hard to go to school and to another school.
然后你长大然后你很努力的去学习从一个学校到另外一个学校到另外一个学校。
And then you get to school to go to a better job.
然后当你学校毕业你去找到一个工作。
So you can get married.
然后你结婚。
So you can get a house.
然后你就买了个房子。
So you can get some car.
然后买了个车。
And children and grandchildren.
然后孙子。
And then you die.
然后你死了。
Okay. And then the point is.
结论就是。
Oh, actually, there's joy in every segment of it. Joy. There's some joy.
就说在每一个过程当中，你会经历一些喜悦。
And it's just an experience of life.
这只是生命的一个经历。
And experiencing life is life's purpose.
所以生命的意义就等同于经历生命。
Really?
是真的吗
？That's it.
真的是这样的吗
？But you have no difference between an animal and you. They're experiencing things too.
你跟动物有什么差别呢？动物也在经历它的生命啊。
And you're no different. They're living for themselves. They have children too, and they die.
他们也有他们自己的生命啊，他们有自己的孩子啊，然后他们就死了。
They're working for food. Yeah, they're working every day.
他们也在工作呀，也在为食物去工作呀。
And then they die.
然后就死了。
Really, that's the meaning of your life?
这是你生命的意义吗
just enjoying the process, and that's it.
哦，就只要享受这个中间的过程。
And you become nothing, dust, and nobody remembers you. You don't remember nothing. It's finished.
然后最后就变成尘土，没人记得你，你也不记得自己。
Is that really the meaning of your life? Is that
这是你生命的意义吗
that really sucks. Really telling you, really it's a garbage.
如果真的是这样的话，那真的是太垃圾了。
You guys really have done a pitiful life.
那你的人生实在是太可怜了。
Okay, you really have no joy, really.
那就真的没有真正的喜乐。
Okay. That is not the meaning of life.
这不是你生命的意义。
The meaning of life is abundant with God and the way we're right now seeking to be one with God.
生命的意义是要在神的里面得着丰盛的这个产业，并且能够在这个过程当中不断的寻求。
And when you meet Him, then it changes.
当你遇见神的时候，你的生命就开始改变。
Now Moses, I told you, he was walking in the field one day, and in the wilderness.
我们知道摩西后来他有一次在田野当中，或在山里面。
And one day he sees a strange thing.
他看到一个很奇怪的现象。
He sees a burning bush.
他看到前面有一个小树丛在燃烧。
It's not that uncommon to see a burning bush in the 沙漠 because you know sometimes trees burn.
在沙漠里面看到树燃烧不是一件特别稀奇的事情。
But this tree.
但是这个树
was not being consumed in the fire.
竟然没有被烧着。有火在烧，但是它没有被烧坏。
There is fire in the tree, and this tree is not being burned up.
这个树上有火在烧，但这个树却依然完好。
And it's a strange sight.
所以这是个很奇怪的一个现象。
He sees this burning bush.
他看到一个燃烧的树丛。
And he sees it.
他看到了。
And he hears a voice of God from that burning bush.
他听到在这个树丛的后面有神的声音对他说。
And he meets God for the first time.
那是他第一次遇见神。
Hears God for the first time.
那是他第一次听到神的声音。
And this burning bush, this burning desire.
而这个燃烧的这个热情，这个欲渴望。
Enters into Moses.
进入到他的里面。
Since then, he becomes a man of God.
自从那一刻开始，摩西变成了一个神的仆人。
Fervent for God.
对神非常的热情。
Always seeking God.
一直去寻求神。
Really. Finding God and really meeting God in daily life and waiting for Him.
他在每一天的生活当中，他都等候神，遇见神和神气。
He later on has a tabernacle. He waits for God. He meets God. He hears God. He talks to God all day long.
后来他造了一个会幕，在这个会幕当中，他几乎每一天都在会幕里面等候神，和神交通，然后听神的话。
Not only that, he gets to fulfill his calling. He delivers all the Israel people out of Egypt with God.
他完成了他自己生命的一个呼召，他就是把整个的埃及的以色列人全部都救出来，脱离了埃及的这个奴隶的这个束缚。
He was a normal person.
他只是一个普通人。
Just like you and me.
就和你和我一样。
But then he starts delivering people out of the Egypt. He delivers them out to be with God.
他救了所有的以色列人，脱离了埃及，使他们能够遇见神。
To lead them to the promised land.
带他们进入到了那个应许之地。
Now we are all 普通人。
我们都是普通人。
Okay. If you meet God.
如果你遇见神。
When you meet God.
当你遇见神的时候。
Something will change.
有一些东西就会被改变，你里面就会被改变。
That you will also become somebody like Moses.
你就会成为像摩西一样的人。
Leading those who don't know God to God.
带领那些不认识神的人去认识神。
And to salvation eventually.
然后进入救恩。
And that is one of the things that gets fulfilled in you when you meet God. Understand?
这个是当我们遇见神的时候，其中需要成就的一件事情。
When the disciples met Jesus, many of them were fishermen.
当耶稣的门徒遇见耶稣的时候，很多的门徒都是打鱼的渔夫。
And they're just fishing all day long.
他们只是每天去打鱼。
Just making money.
然后赚钱。
Okay, just making money. That's all.
他们就是去打鱼赚钱。
And they will die if they didn't meet Jesus.
如果他们没有遇到耶稣，他们就这样死掉了。
Meaningless.
没有任何的意义。
But Jesus said to them clearly.
但是耶稣对他们说
，Come.
来。
Follow me.
跟随我。
And I will make you.Fishers of men.
我要让你得人如得鱼。
You're not going to be a fishing fish anymore, which is meaningless.
打鱼的渔夫。
But now you'll be a much more higher value person.
你要做一个更加有价值的人。
You'll be fishers of men.
你要做那个得人灵魂的渔夫。
You'll save them into everlasting life.
你要救人能够进入到永恒的生命里面。
And that is a higher calling.
这是一个更高的呼召。
When you meet God,
当你遇见神的时候
，not only your destiny will change,
不仅仅是你的命运会被改变
，your goal in life will change,
你生命的目标也会被改变。
Before you be chasing after useless things of this world,
可能以前你的目标是要追寻这个世上的这些
，oh better shoes,
无用的东西
，nicer shoes,
啊，买一双更漂亮的鞋子
，oh better clothing,
更好的衣服
，oh better purse,
更好的钱包
，better house,
更好的房子
，oh better husband,
更好的丈夫。
Better. Always just looking for better things.
总是在寻求的是什么更好的东西
？Oh, just better job, if anything. Oh, give me better, more money.
更好的工作，收入更高的工作。
But does it make you happy?
那这些东西真的带给你快乐吗
？No.
不是的。
It makes you stressful.
让你很有压力。
Oh yeah, you might have some happiness here and there. Oh,
你可能在这个过程当中有一点点快乐。
But your life?
但是你的生命。
Is tired.
是非常的疲惫的。
And people take their life and go to suicide.
很多人受不了这样的生命就去自杀。
Because they cannot find meaning out of this.
因为他们实在找不出。
They cannot find meaning.
在这样的生命当中有什么活着的意义
？Out of pleasure.
在这种享乐里面找不到什么生命的意义。
Oh, so I got something.
就算我得着了什么东西。
Tomorrow.
明天呢
？You need something more.
还需要更多的东西。
Next day, you forget you just.
然后第二天。又忘记了，又要再找更多的东西。
Great food today.
今天你吃了很棒的食物。
Tomorrow you're hungry again.
明天你又会饥饿。
You know, in America, you know, they run from girlfriend, boyfriend to boyfriend to girlfriend. Okay.
在美国，很多人从一个女朋友到另外一个女朋友，到另外一个女朋友，就一直在这样寻找。
Oh, this girlfriend found a true love.
以为这个女生哦找到真爱了。
She leaves you.
她离开了。
Or he leaves you.
或他男的也离开了。
Okay. Oh, next one.Oh, he leaves you. She leaves you. Gone.
或者，这个又离开，那个又离开。
Okay, there is no actual meaning to this. Okay,
在这个过程当中没有真正的意义。
It just and then you get old.
然后你就老去了。
And then people get cancer. They die. You know, get diseases. Die. You know.
很多人得了病，得了癌症，然后就死掉了。
Some people die early. Get accidents. Die early.
有些人出了事故，可能死得很年轻。
Nothing gets better. It gets worse and worse and worse. Life gets worse.
而生命只是变得越来越糟糕，没有变得更好。
But Moses at age 80.
但是摩西在八十岁的时候，他遇见了神。
His life started changing.
他的生命发生了完全的改变。
When he was dying.
当他准备要就是离世了。
Bible records that his strength was still like a young man.
圣经上描述说，当摩西真正去世之前，圣经上说他的那个力量跟年轻的时候一样。
And his eyes have not gone dim.
他的眼睛没有昏花。
Actually, get better. You know, all these things get better than before.
世界都变得越来越好。
Because he constantly had a connection with God.
因为他一直与神相连。
Now, I'm telling you.What many of us we just have religious behaviors.
我们中间的很多人都是只有一个宗教的行为。
You think you need to do something?
你觉得你需要去做一些事情。
So you do a little bit with God.
然后你就会去做一点点跟神有关的事情。
Oh, just to survive, just to survive.
好像就是为了要活下去，生存下去。
Just to survive spiritually.
为了在你的灵里面能够好像生存下去。
Just to breathe a little better.
好像能够更好的呼吸一点。
That is not the purpose.
这不是你生命的意义。
Why you should be seeking God in the first place?
你为什么一开始的时候不去寻求神
？When I start seeking God.
当我一开始寻求神的时候。
Okay. After I you know, first time, you know, seeking God, like fasting and praying.
我第一次进食祷告了，结束。
And I even turned up my cell phone to seek the Lord for one month.
我那个时候一个月的时间把手机关掉。
I was, I'm not even going to connect with my friends and family, whatever. I'm just going to turn it off.
我决心说这一个月我甚至不要跟我任何的朋友家人去联系。
I'm just going to seek God. I really want to seek.
我就要去寻求神，我真的很想去寻求神。
Of course, I had a lot of problems, and I was really desperate for God.
当然，我那时候也有很多的问题，所以我对神是非常的迫切。
And when I really heard God for the first time,
而后来一个月以后，我第一次听到了神的声音。
And received the gift of tongues.
然后领受了方言的恩赐。
I was like, wow, this is cool.
我当时觉得很觉得很酷。
I feel like electricity coming in my heart, you know, psh, 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 like that. Oh, this is pretty cool.
我感觉到神像电流一样的流到我的身上。
I was like, "What's next?"
我就在想，那下一个是什么呢
？Next thing, I go to this church. I go to this church.
然后下一件事情，当我去教会的时候。
And at the time, I was still addicted to cigarettes.
我那个时候抽烟很厉害。
Okay, and this pastor says, "Anybody who's addicted to cigarettes, just come up, right?"
然后那个牧师说，你们中间谁有上瘾的，来到台前。
And in the midst of it, I go to the stage, and fire came down from.Ceiling, literally, like fire just come down and then burn throughout me.
啊，当我踏上那个台阶的时候，我亲眼看见从天花板上降下一个火球，淋到我的身上。
And this is what kind of like broke me.
就是这样的经历让我很破碎。
It broke my thinking.
它破碎了我之前的想法。
God can be this real in this life?
我在想说，哇，神在今生可以这么真实吗
？Can God really, be met in this life?
在这个今生神真的可以被遇见吗
All I've heard before from other people was that
我以前听到所有的别人讲的事情
They never seen God in their life
那些人从来没有见过神
They never heard God but they think they know God is real you know,
他们也没有听到神的声音但他们知道神是真的
And I see this fire
当我看到这个火球淋到我身上的时候
It kind of broke my thinking I was like, whoa, this is unheard of
所以当我看到这个火球淋下来的时候，我这个整个价值观都被打破了，因为我想这种是从来没听说过的事情。
Because it's not even the pastor doing anything yet.
因为那个时候牧师还没有做任何的事情，牧师还没开始祷告。
After I received the fire, people were still going up, and then he started to pray.
所有的人群都在往楼梯上走，我只是在走的这个过程当中，我就看到这个火球。
And I knew that oh, this pastor doesn't even know about it, probably, you know.
我知道那个牧师甚至都不知道当时发生了什么事情。
God doing it.
这个是神在我面前做的。
Next day I go to church.
第二天我去教会。
I went there early because this is something different in this church. Okay.
我去的很早，因为那个教会很奇特，很不一样。
I see a lot of people praying.And、
看到很多人的祷告。
See another pastor in the front.
我看到前面有一个牧师。
And I go and ask him, "Hey, you guys talk a lot about Holy Spirit here. You know, how do you get to know it better?"
我就问那个牧师说，哎，你们老是讲圣灵的，我怎么样可以更多认识圣灵
？I was hungry to know God more.
我心里非常的渴慕。
I was hungry.
很渴慕，我很想认识神。
I want to experience more.
我想要经历更多。
This fire was not enough.
那个火球我看到的不满足，不够。
So he said, "Wow, that's a great question."
然后那牧师说啊，这是个很好的问题。
Talk to him.
你要和圣灵说话。
Talk to Holy Spirit.
和圣灵对话。
You mean pray to him, right?
我就在想说祷告吗？你是说祷告吗
？No, you pray to the Father.
我说不是，你祷告，你奉耶稣的名对阿爸父祷告。
You talk to the Holy Spirit, who's here?
你跟圣灵对话，圣灵就在你这里。
He's here.
他就在这里。
And he showed me some scriptures from the beginning. There's Spirit, God, and all these things. Okay.
然后他给我看了一些经文，讲这个圣灵从起初一直到现在都。
And when Jesus went up, he said, "I don't want to leave you orphans."
耶稣当他走的时候，他说：“我不会留下你们做孤儿。”
I go to heaven.
我去天堂。
So that Father can send you the Holy Spirit to you.
这样天父就可以差遣圣灵来到你们中间。
And he will teach you all things.
他会教导你所有的事情。
That you must know. He will lead you, guide you.
他会将你所需要，他都会告诉你。
Okay. So Jesus leads us to the Holy Spirit.
所以耶稣带我们认识了圣灵。
So we can, with him, know Jesus and know the Father on earth and experience him on earth.
And we, 借着圣灵，可以更多的认识耶稣，认识天父，以及经历他们。
So at the time, I just don't know anything much Bible. I didn't know much Bible. I just come down to my seat.
我那时候对圣经非常的不熟悉。
Since I never spoke to Holy Spirit, I just pray. Holy Spirit.
我就回到我自己的座位上，然后我就祷告，我就跟圣灵祷告。
If you're real, let me know you.
我就对圣灵说。圣灵，如果你是真的，请你让我认识你。
And this is what you should start with.
这是你们需要开始的这个。
Start with, if you really want to have a connection with God, right?
如果你真的很想跟神连接，你就要开始这样。
Then, while they're worshiping the Lord, there's some Holy Spirit raining down.
然后当他们开始一起敬拜，有一首歌叫《圣灵恩雨降下》。
Oh, what kind of song is Holy Spirit raining down? R-E-I-N, you know?
我现在想，圣灵怎么是雨呢？怎么像雨一样降下来呢？
Yeah, I was like, I don't want to sing like this.
我就觉得我不要这样唱。
So I said, oh, maybe that R-E-I-N means like R-E-I-G-N.
我就在想，可能这个雨
change it poetically.
这个雨可能是另外一个 rain, 同样的发音，但是指的是统治，就是圣灵来统治这里的意思。
So I said, oh, maybe they're just singing poetically.
我想可能
Holy Spirit rain on us, rain on us.
然后我当时就想说
you should rain on our life.
我当时讲，可能他们是想要就是押韵，或讲得好听一点，才用这个下雨的雨。然后我就按照我自己的理解去唱那个统治的那个意思去唱。
Biblically, God should rule over in your life.
因为按照圣经的教导，的确神要来掌管我们的生命。
He's your 主，
他是我们的主人。
He's your master,
他是我们的主。
He's your 王，
他是我们的王。
Okay, 王 has son and Ichi, right? 主 has also son and Ichi. Well, Jesus, Holy Spirit, Father, three in one.
你看主和王中文都是三条横线一条竖杠、三位一体的神是连接在一起的。
God is supposed to be your master.
神是我们的主
and our Lord.
是我们的王。
Just don't say it out of your own, draw, draw, and then don't do his will, right? This kind of doesn't make sense, does it?
不要总是说、哦、主啊主啊但是却不把他当成你的主。
You don't do his will, then hey, you're lying. Oh, there's burning. It's burning, burning.Burn, burn, burn.
你帮我看一下那个土豆有没有烧熟啊？那你就关了吧，关了。嗯，关了。
So, you're lying if you say 主啊主啊 and then don't do what he wants you to do. Okay, you're lying.
所以我们说主啊主啊，但是如果不把它当成主，我们就在撒谎。
So, anyway, so I said, Lord, rain down on us.
所以我当时就唱歌，我说主啊，你来掌管我们。
Another miracle.
然后又发生了一个神迹。
Okay. Start raining down fire rain all over the place while this song is going on, while this worship song is going on.
当这个唱歌的时候，我突然就看见从天上降下来圣灵的火一样。
Now I'm just standing here, okay? And then I hear a sound like.
我本来是闭着眼睛在唱歌，然后就听到声音在我的肩膀上。
I see.
我就抬头一看。
My shoulders are like fire.
我就看到有很多的火星临到我的身上
like down, like all over, right?
我就看到整个会堂全部都是火雨降下来
and I looked out, looked everywhere, coming everywhere.
我就左右看就看到整个火雨临到了所有的地方
and I closed my eyes, we're just looking at everybody singing, everybody singing like this
因为所有人都闭上眼睛在唱歌
I still see the fire
当我眼睛闭上
it's like flickering, entering me, but it's hot, it's warm, it's like crazy, okay?
我依旧看到这个火雨降在我
身上 I'm talking about like 3 to 4 minutes straight
三四分钟那首歌
You know, it's a 3-4 minutes a pretty long time, okay?
三四分钟是很长的
You know, you can try to test out. It goes, oh, this is cool, you know, what is this? You know, you look, look around.
I mean, 我有一段时间可以去检测
Is anybody else singing this song? It seems like nobody sings. It's just me, okay? I'm just singing this, okay?
然后我四周环望想看有没有人看到同样的事情
And it really changes your mind, like
真的改变了我的
It really changes your mind.
改变了我的想法
Wow, it's so real.
上帝是这么真实的。
It's not, I'm not even dreaming. It's, I'm not even sleeping. Okay.
我都不是在睡觉，我没有在做梦。
Okay, I'm not even drugged up. I don't have any, you know, alcohol in me. I'm not drunk.
我也没有喝酒，我只是去教会去礼拜。
As it's coming, I feel like so happy.
啊，当这个火雨淋到我身上的时候，我感到非常的快乐。
Not that it's so cool. Okay.
不是因为看到这个情景很酷。
Wow, finally meeting God right now. I'm really meeting God.My spirit is really meeting God.
是一种极大的喜乐，是我真的遇见神了。
Okay. Wow, this is like so out of the ordinary thing. You know, it's like nobody see this, nobody heard this. I'm here experiencing God's fire in real life. I'm like, wow. This
因为这个不是普通的事情，也不是普通人的事，这超出了我的想象。
And then, you know, I'm like, because of this event, I'm listening to the preacher, and then this preacher said, oh, he gave up everything to follow God. Okay, he gave up everything to follow God.
然后来那天。那个牧师就讲到，他说
，He sold his house and whatever is whatever. He just followed God from then, you know.
然后那个牧师就讲到说，他放弃了所有的东西，房子、车子，全部所有的去跟随神。
And he tells me he meets Jesus every day.
然后他说他每一天都遇见耶稣。
Praying and he sees God and he sees Jesus. He meets Jesus.
他每天祷告，他就遇见耶稣。
And he said, "This is not just for me." He said, "This is for everybody. Everybody, everybody can meet Jesus."
他说这个不是我的人生，是你们每个人都可以经历的人生。
And he's like, "Are you willing to pay the price?" Are you willing to pay that price to meet him?
然后那个牧师就说，你愿不愿意摆上这个代价去遇见神？ Ina stop.
And he said, when he left up everything, left everything, gave everything to God.
他让他放弃所有东西去跟随神的时候。
Then God, of course, provided him everything.
神供应了他所有的东西。
At the time, I didn't have much. I was like kind of like not that the rich. Okay, I was kind of poor.
我那个时候还蛮穷的，没有什么钱。
I was really like a, you know, just a poor American guy. Okay, all I had was like guitar and musical instruments. That's it.
我只有很多音乐的这个器具，但是我很穷的一个美国人。
And you know when they send this like you know these offering baskets around, you know when.
所以当他们在啊、
okay?
传递那个奉献袋的时候。
I didn't have much.
我并没有什么很多。
So the envelope I just said I give myself.And I wrote down.
然后在那个
envelope, I wrote it down.
然后在那个信封上面，他就写，别人都写那个支票号码或者什么金额，他写说，我把我自己给神。
Yeah, because I was, it feels like I was willing to really sell everything, whatever I have. It's not that much.
我当时就下了一个决心
guitar, whatever favorite things, you know, I was willing to sell it all.
我当时就下了一个决心说，我把我所有的一切，所有的钱，我都愿意卖掉去给神。
And yeah, I was like just you know willing to do everything.
Okay. 我愿意做所有的事情。
Since then, I start seeking God really early in the morning because this pastor said, "Hey, you know, he wake up 3 in the morning and pray and then seek God and like you know, he meets God and worship the Lord like all day long, worship the God, you know."
所以从那一刻开始，我开始每天早上清晨起来就去寻求神，因为那个牧师讲说他每天早上很早就起来祷告、读经，然后去敬拜、
and、
寻求神。
And he read the Bible because he was so hungry for God's word. He's like, so read the Bible, read it, read it, read it, read it, read it.
然后那个牧师一直读圣经，一直读圣经，
you know?
因为他非常渴慕神的话语。
He just wanted God so much.
他非常渴望更多的得着神。
And he's like, he finally had that, you know.
然后他最终得着了。
And I was like, I want that too. I want that too. I want that too.
我就想说，我也要有这样的一个
生命。So if you can do it, I can do it too. You know why not?
他能够做，我也能做。
Okay, why not? I can do it.
我也能做的，他能做，我也能做。
We can do it. We just choose to do something else.
我们其实都能做，只是我们决定去做别的事情。
Yeah, if you stop watching your cell phone and just give it up and don't watch any movies or TVs and things like that, you seek God, and you can have enough time to seek God.
如果你能够摆脱你的手机，不去看那些视频、电影或者是。
And don't hang out with your friends. Yeah, you can definitely seek God if you wanted to.
然后不去和你的朋友交往，你可以单独的花时间去亲近神。
Okay, I have hundreds of friends. Okay,
我原来有一百多个朋友，全部都放弃掉。
All drinking buddies. Okay,
因为那些人都是跟我喝酒的朋友。
All those buddies. Okay,
狐朋狗友。
Whatever, all those you know party friends. Okay,
都是一些派对的朋友。
Nothing good for you. They're nothing good for you. Okay, you think they're good at the time, but They're not really good for you.
但那个时候觉得很快乐，但是其实他们对我没有任何的益处。
So give up all these things, you know, that I do, and then really, I went to school too. I was busy. I'm not, you know, free. I went to school. I did do homework. Okay.
然后我还上学，那时候我有做很多作业。
But I dedicated the rest of the time, every second I have, every minute I have, read Bible, pray, and just.Look for God. I want to meet God. It's my purpose.
但是我自己下定了一个决心，就是除了我做作业的这个时间、读书的时间以外，接下来剩余的空余时间的每一分钟，我都奉献给神。
And,
我就不断的祷告、读经，去寻求神。
And in the midst, I go to church every day, every night, because they were meeting every night. We went to church every night.
而在这个过程当中，我每天都去教会，因为那时候教会每天都有聚会。
Okay, and I just wanted to absorb everything what he's saying, like how to do this, how to do this.Just a lot of you know functional methods, you know, but I wanted to just do them all.
那个牧师分享了很多他的方法方式，我就很拼命的去吸收，想要去做每一件事情。
What I want you to get is,
我想让你们明白的是
you need to really want to connect with God and meet God today in this age while you're alive.
是你自己必须要有一个渴望，你渴望在今生能够遇见神。
If you don't meet God.
因为如果你不遇见神
Then what are you doing? It's wasting time.
那你所做的所有的事情都是在浪费时间，你连教会也不用来，因为来教会也是浪费时间。
When you're worshiping the Lord.
当我们敬拜神的时候
If you're just like just standing around and don't sing, you know?
如果你就把手往口袋里面一插，然后就也不唱。
How can you connect with God?
你想怎么样去连接神？
If you go back home today and don't pray,
如果你今天回家以后你又不祷告
and earnestly pray to meet God, earnestly pray with your heart out,
是很热和很真诚的去祷告，把你的心摆上去祷告。
Then how will you meet God?
那你不然的话，你怎么能够遇见神
？Right? If you don't cut off your sins,
如果你不切断你的罪
or at least will to, will to cut off your sins.
或者至少是你渴望切断你的罪。
How can you meet God?
你怎么能够遇见神？
I mean, when God took away my girlfriend that time.
那个时候神把我的女朋友带走的时候。
Remember, I said I was angry at God. I was yelling at God.
我告诉我分享过你给你们，我当时很生气，我对神大吼大叫。
I just drank a lot.
我喝很多很多的酒
My heart still hurt.
我的心还是很痛
I smoke a lot,
我抽很多的烟
My heart still hurt.
我心还是很痛
Nothing is healing this.
没有什么可以医治我的心
And I got angry at God.
然后我对神很生气
Say, God, why did you let the devil take her away?、Why?
我对神说神啊 你干嘛叫撒旦把这个女孩子带走
I was really like serious. I was like, really, God, why you take her away from me?
我当时真的很认真我对神说你为什么要把这个女生带走
And then God gave me thatShocking message.
All 然后神给了我一个很
came to me.
然后神给我一个很震惊的一个信息
Because you loved her more than me.
神跟我说，因为你爱她超过爱我
That was it.
然后结束了
Okay. But, you know, since that thing was all broken,
既然这些都破碎掉了
and I gave up all that,
然后把这些都放弃掉了
But God gave me everything else.
然后神将我想要都赐给我了
But my motive was not to get everything else.
但是我的动机不是想要。
My real motive was not to get a wife.
我的动机不是想要得到。
Although God gave, okay.
虽然神也给了我妻子。
My motive was not to find, financial comfort or healing or deliverance.
我寻求神的动机也不是为了得着经济上的帮助或者是什么心灵的安慰。
Or get healed of my diseases or my sleeping habit, whatever it is.
或者是我一些疾病一些问题都要解决。
My motive was to really.Mika,
我的动机是我真的想要遇见他
Okay, I was hungry, like for the truth, for the real thing in life.
我对真理很渴望
And the result as a result.
而结果
I meet God in 2 months. You know?
结果是我两个月以后遇见了神
You know, Jesus, I see heaven and I see hell. I see all kinds of teacher.
我看到天使，看到天堂，看到地狱，看到耶稣。
About 3-4 days ago, when I was seeking God early in the morning and praying, because that's the time when you meet God, right?
三四天前，在我祷告的时候，凌晨三四点钟，我在祷告的时候，那个时候是我们遇见神的时间。
Okay, I have a dream.
我做了一个梦。
A pretty clear dream, and I see like you know houses outside.
我看到外面有很多。
My window.
我看到我的窗外有很多房子
And I see an angel's feet touch another window and jump over here, like kind of like flying, like floating over here.
然后我看到一个天使，他的脚踩着另外一个房子，然后朝我这儿飞过来。
She looked like white person, okay, kind of like a white person looking like.
有点像白人的样子。
Blonde hair kind of thing.
金头发的。
And then she's like, hi, like that.
然后那天使对我说 hi.
And I was like, well, Wendy, the tree. I was like, Wendy, there's an angel coming to room.
他就赶紧叫文丽，赶紧过来看。
I was like,
房间里有个天使
come see
过来
too.
过来看天使。
And of course, she wasn't there, you know, because it's a dream.
因为那是个梦，所以我当然不在那里。
Yeah, then I wake out of the dream, but that was like, so real, you know.
但是那个梦很真实。
Have I seen a real angel in while awake? Yeah, I've seen it too.
我在现实中我也看到过天使。
When she went to the room because and she started crying bitterly because she found out, you know, maybe God showed her she's very prideful or something.
Uh-huh.
And then she's crying because of her.Pride, you know? Right.
有一次当我因为神告诉我我很骄傲的这个事情，然后我到房间，我到衣橱里面哭了很长很长的时间去悔改。
She prayed from like maybe she's
cried
from like 12 o'clock to 3.
到凌晨三点。
Yeah, about 3 hours, okay? 3 hours, and I was like, oh my goodness, she's like sleeping. Can I like even sleep? She's so loud. She's like in the room crying, and I'm like just going back and forth. And finally, I see she come back, you know, to her room, okay?
然后我觉得她特别的吵，声音又很大，我没有办法睡觉，我就翻来覆去的睡不着。
And I look like this. I was like in the bed, okay? Because look at me.
然后我当时就躺在这个床上，就看她走出来。
And I look to the side.
我就转过去看她。
Oh, and an angel is standing right next to her, like this.
然后就看到在她的旁边有一个天使站在旁边。
You know, and I see the hair, golden hair. I don't see the eyes, but I see golden hair, like this kind of, you know, this kind of shape.
然后看到她那个金色的头发，在她的头旁边。
Like kind of curly, okay?
看到一个金色的头发。
And right there, there's a very white, you know, person.
她的完全白色的衣服，纯白的衣服。
Kind of like this, like a Roman kind of old times clothes.
有点像罗马旧时那种服装。
Okay, I was like, oh, that's an angel, you know? It's an angel right here, you know?
然后有个天使。
But I was kind of like so tired, it's 3 o'clock in the morning. I was like, oh my god, you know, there's an angel here, you know, just like just go to sleep, okay?
但是那个三点钟太累了，他天使睡着了，睡觉了。
Yeah, I was so tired. It was 3 o'clock.
还是做梦？
不是做梦。
No, it's not a dream. I saw it there. You know, but yeah, things like this. Okay.
这些事情。
Things like this is Does the Bible say it?
这难道圣经里面没有讲过吗？这不是圣经里应许的事情吗？
Moses even saw the back of God, okay?
摩西看到神的背面。
Jesus saw, I mean, not Jesus saw, the disciples saw Jesus being transfigured into the person of light.
他的耶稣的门徒也看到耶稣在山上变形。
And they saw Moses and Elijah, who's supposed to be dead, or Elijah's not, but
他们在山上还看到摩西和以利亚。
Many people, John sees a revelation all in vision, all whole thing in vision.
约翰看到了很多的这个异象。
Every 先知 they all see visions kind of stuff.
这些先知都能看到异象。
Daniel too, everybody too.
但以利他们都能看到。
They have some experiences with God, or real supernatural experiences with God in the Bible.
他们都有很多和神这种超自然的这种经历。
Paul sees visions.
保罗看到异象。
Anna sees visions in the New Testament.
安娜也看到异象。
Okay, what's the difference now?
如今有什么不一样呢？
Any difference today?
现在有什么不一样呢？
Jesus, what? The Holy Spirit finished or something?
圣灵结束了吗？没有的。
Did he taken away from here?
圣灵被带走了吗？没有。
He's gone? No, he's not gone.
圣灵没有被带走。
All those things are Jesus. God is same yesterday, today, forever, right? God is yesterday, today, forever.
神是以前、现在跟以后都是一样的神。
That means the same thing.
意思说同样的事情
can obviously happen today as well if you seek God. If you seek God,
也可以发生在你的身上，只要你去寻求神。
Now, in Isaiah 58 tells you why you're blocked.
以赛亚书的第
58
章讲到说我们为什么
why you are cut off from God.
为什么你被拦住
why you have no connection with God.
为什么你跟神没有连接的原因？以赛亚书第几章？
五十八
章。第九节，二到九节。
他们天天寻求我，乐于明白我的道，叫人垂头向尾子，用麻布和炉灰铺在他以下吗？你这可称为禁食，为耶和华所悦纳的日子吗？我所拣选的禁食，不是要松开凶恶的绳，卸下恶上的锁，使被欺，那时你若从中间不要坠落和指摘人的指头，并发恶言的事。
Yeah, so it says, hey, you know, what is blocking you? Even while you're fasting, doing all these religious activities.
当我们进食，当我们做一些宗教的活动，什么东西拦阻我们？
Reading Bible,
祷告读经。
Why aren't you able to? Why aren't you able to meet God?
Go to the room.
It says, do good while you're seeking the Lord, right? And cut away all the wickedness.
他说你们要行公义，要切断你之前做犯罪的行为。
And do good unto the people who are poor.
对那些穷的人要发怜悯，有善心。
Because you cannot come to God wickedly.
因为你不能到神面前是带着一个邪恶的心。
Let's go to 59, the next chapter.
然后看一下五十九章。
一节。
第一节。和第二节一到三，耶和华的膀臂并非缩短，不能拯救；耳朵并非发沉，不能听见。但你们的罪孽使你们与神隔绝，你们的罪恶使他掩面不听你们。因你们的手被血沾染，你们的指头被罪孽玷污，你们的嘴唇说谎言，你们的舌头出恶语。
Understand? Amen. It's not that he cannot hear you, he cannot come. It's your sins are blocking in the way.
不是说他不能听见，不能帮助你，是因为你的罪拦阻了神。
Now, when Adam and Eve sinned, they got cut away from God.
当亚当和夏娃犯罪的时候，他们就跟神隔绝了。
God has so loved them.
但是神非常的爱他们。
And God has so loved us.
神也非常的爱我们。
He gave us the Lord Jesus Christ's body.
他把
and his blood.
主耶稣的宝血来
as a payment for our sins.
作为我们罪的一个赎价。
So when we are cleansed by His blood,
当我们被主耶稣的宝血洁净了以后
，as we repent of our sins, it's not that, you know, He don't want you to be. He wants you so much that He's willing to give up His own Son,
不是说他
Holy begotten Son.
不想要你，他非常的想要得着我们，以至于他愿意把自己的儿子牺牲了，来换回我们。
So that He can reconnect with you, it is His will to connect with you again.
是他的旨意。他的旨意要来与我们重新相连。
And I'll tell you, there is a meaning of your life.
而在这个过程当中，你能找到你生命的意义。
There's a real meaning of your life.
这是你真正生命的意义。
You were created by Him.
你被他创造。
For Him.
为他创造。
For His love.
为他的爱。
You're supposed to have a love relationship with God.
你本来是应该和他建立一个爱的关系。
As a father has with his own child.
就像父亲和孩子之间的关系一样。
The same father.
同样的父亲。
Wants the same love to be poured on you, and you also love him back.
他希望他渴望将他的爱倾倒在你的身上，让你可以以你的爱去回应他。
Even though we mess up so much.
即使我们犯了很多很多的错误。
He wants you.Really back and have a real connection with him again.
但是他渴望你能够回来，也渴望和你重新建立这样的一个关系。
This religious activity right here.
我们现在做这些所谓宗教的活动。
If you don't connect with God.
如果你不连接于神。
Wasting time.
你就在浪费时间。
Wasting time.
你就在浪费时间。
Understand? Want to connect with God.
你要与他相连。
And there is everything in him. Everything.
当你和他相连的时候，你所有的一切都在他的里面。
Your future, your money, your husband, your wife, your whatever.
你的未来。
Everything is in him.
你的经济，你的丈夫妻子都在他的里面。
All the problems of your problems all be solved in him.
你的问题会得到全部的解决。
Whether it be a health problem, whatever problem, mind problem,
不管是你思想上的问题，心灵的问题，身体的问题。
Whatever problem is all solved in him.
都可以得到解决。
But that is not even the reason why you come to him.
但是这些问题的解决不是重点。
Is that finally you can be one with him in fullness.
而是你最终可以与他完全的合二为一。
Understand? And that is true joy, true happiness when you connect with him.
而在那里有真正的喜乐。
When you pray in tongues.
当你祷告的时候。
当
你方言祷告的时候。
You know, you have to receive the gift. Some people receive the gifts here.
有些人在这里有方言祷告的恩赐。
Don't just pray in tongues, okay?
不要仅仅是方言祷告。
Connect with him.
你要与他相连。
Say, Lord, I want to meet you here.
你跟神说，神啊，我想要认识你。
I'm going to pray until I meet you.
我要祷告直到我遇见你。
Until I feel you, I'm filled with you.
直到我感觉到你，直到我被你充满。
Praying in tongues, it's not enough, okay?
仅仅是方言祷告是不够的。
When you fast.You do it, I want to meet you, God.
当你进食的时候，你要一个我要遇见你的心态进
食。I need you here right now in me, right now I need you.
是我在此时此刻，今天我就要遇见你。
Why are you wasting time, right? Why are you wasting time?
不然我们何必要浪费时间？
You have to meet him.
你一定要遇见他。
Pointless.
不然都是没有意义的。
If you pray and you don't meet him,
如果你祷告但没有遇见他，
pray stronger, more biblically.
那你就更加要努力祷告，并且按照圣经的方式去祷告。
Cry out unto me.
圣经上说你要大声的呼求，向我。
Come with me with all your heart, not half your heart, all your heart.
要带着全部的心来到神的面前，不是一半的心。
Use your body, your voice, you know, your heart, your mind, everything.
摆上你所有的，你的身体，你的声音，你的心灵，你的这个思想，全部都摆上。
Of course, you can pray in tongues and do stuff, but.You should get rid of all those stuff and then focus on him.
虽然我们可以一边方言祷告一边做其他的事情，但是你也需要花出时间单独去寻求神。
When you read the Bible, don't just be mechanical. I have to read the Bible. No, don't do like that.
读圣经不要把它当成一个任务，好像我今天必须要读到几章。
Tell the Lord, talk to the Lord.
你要跟神去讲话。
I want to meet you.
你跟神说我要遇见你。
I want to know you.
我要在读圣经的时候我要遇见你。
I want to learn you.
我要学习你，我要认识你。
I want to get to know you.
我要认识你。
What is the purpose if you just don't do anything like that and just read the Bible? You become a Pharisee.
如果你不是想要遇见神，就是为了读圣经而读圣经，那你跟法利赛人就没有什么区别。
If you don't have a meeting with it, it will not change your life.
如果你不遇见他，这些都改变不了你的生命。
Do you understand? It will not change you if you just play game with God. It's not going to change.
如果你只是在跟神玩游戏，这不会改变你任何的生命。
Don't play any games with him.
跟神不要玩任何的游戏。
He's real.
他很真实。
This life, this is, as you know, your life is real. He is really real.
就像你知道你现在你的生命是真实的，他也是真实的。
Okay, and he can really change you.
他也真的能够改变你。
And you will become fishers of men.
你就会
when you meet him.
成为得人灵魂的
all your wicked life that you lived before will all be changed by him when you meet him, when you connect with him finally.
当你遇见他的时候，你过去所有这些邪恶的生活方式都会被改变。
He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. He will reward you.
他是那些赏，他会赏赐那些认真寻求他的人。
It's not just knowledge, okay? It's not just knowledge. You will feel him, you'll see him, you'll know him.
这不是只是知识。 你会真的经历他，认识他，看见他，
only,
听到他。
If you only know by now, you messed up. You're already messing up.
如果你只是在知识上面知道，那你就已经是在很糟糕的处境了。
You really meet him, feel him, know him, touch him. It should be tangible.
你要去真的去看到他，听到他，认识他，感觉到他，他是可触摸的。
The kingdom of God is not here and there, but it's within you.
圣经上说，神的国不是在那边还是这边，是在你的里面。
Where is God?Where is he? He's right here.
神就在你的里面。
Okay? Understand? Now, not only that, not only that, when you seek God, the kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violent take it by force.
实际上说、
okay?
神的国是要遭受暴力的、啊、这个强夺的人会把它强夺夺回来夺过来。
It's not just seeking a little bit or 10 minutes, okay, I'm going to invest him. No, no, no.
不是每天说花个十分钟给神就够了。
With all your heart, put forth every time, every single moment you have, you really trying to get God into you every day of your life, and there He is.
而是你的每一刻，你生命的每一个空闲的时间，你都渴望去更多的得着神。
Okay, don't be satisfied where you are. If you have no growth, you're dead faith. Understand?
如果不要满足你现在一个处境。
If you believe in God and nothing's getting better.
如果你相信神，但是你的生命没有任何的好转。
But you're like just going back sometimes and just coming up, going back sometimes. It's, this is a dead thing.
如果你只是在世界上玩一玩，然后来信心这边教会里面来一下，然后这只是一个死掉的信心。
That means you have not grasped the real gospel. You have not grasped it, guys.
说明你还没有真正的领悟到福音的意义。
Now I was really, I was like praying and suffering for you guys. Okay. Okay. Oh God, please, Lord.These people are not being changed. They're not growing. They're not meeting God. They're, what's wrong? What's wrong with the picture? You know, I'm teaching all the methods. Nobody's really doing it. What's the problem? You know?
我在神面前祈祷祷告，为了你们的人，为了你们去祷告。我跟神说，神啊，我们的人不认识神，不连接神，到底是哪里出错了？我教导了你的方式，为什么？这个问题还是存在？为什么大家没有办法经历到神
？And I know that, you know.You know, people are always more like going back, drawn back to the world. Okay, a lot of times.
因为我知道人总是喜欢往回走，总是喜欢回到世界里面。
Instead of going forward, if they're not continually educated, and you know, if I don't tell you, you know, experience and whatever every day, if they stop hearing the word of God, they'll just take off. Okay.
我意识到说，如果我们的百姓不经常的待在神里面，不断的听神的话语，那他们就很快就会退步。
You know why?
你知道为什么吗
？Do you know why?
你知道为什么这样的
？Because the devil comes to you, brings all the riches of the world, okay?
因为撒旦会来到你的面前，带领你所有的你想要做的事情。
Oh, watch this movie.
看这个新电影吧。
Oh, watch this drama. Oh, it's cool.
看这个电视剧吧，这个很好玩。
Oh, don't you want to buy new shoes?
你不想买新鞋子吗
？Don't you want to buy new clothes?
你不想买新衣服吗
？Don't you want to do something better?
你不想要做更好的事情
？Something good?
你不想吃点好东西吗
？It gives all the thoughts into you.
给你很多的想法。
I want to eat. Forget this thing. Okay.
以及你所想都是吃的、喝的、玩的。
So the devil is pulling you back.
然后撒旦就把你
slowly pulling you. Come over here. Don't go over there.Come over here.
然后撒旦就把你慢慢的往
All your friends call you. Let's go hang out. Oh, this girl is. Oh, she's so beautiful. Come over see her. Oh, come see him. Oh, meet him. No.
你的朋友会给你打电话，出来玩，出来约会，或者很多的事情。
If you don't make a strong decision,
如果你心里
I'm gonna let down everything and then seek him first, then you don't get him. Do you understand?
如果你心里不下一个决心，说我真的要放下所有去寻求神
，Because you're seeking,
那你就会失败的。
You're seeking God.Okay?
因为你是在寻求神。
The highest of all, he's even more better than the president. Okay, he's more important than the president. He's a creator of the world. Okay.
你要寻求的是这个创造宇宙的神，他创造了整个世界。
He's the king of the
universe. 比这些什么总统啊、主席啊要
whole universe
要高尊贵的多。
And then you're gonna seek him half-heartedly, but he knows.
你如果是半一半的心去寻求他。他是清清楚楚的知道的。
Bible is a promise. You seek him, seek me with all your heart, and you will find me. It's a promise.
圣经上有一个神的应许，他说：“你们若全心的寻求我，你们一定会寻找我的，一定会寻找。”
This cannot lie. If it lies, then this Bible needs to be broken.
如果这个圣经撒谎，那这个就不是我们的圣经了。
Okay. If God lies, he's not God.
如果神撒谎，神就不是神了。
It's a promise.
这是他的应许。
So make a decision.
所以，请你们下一个决心。
Oh, in your life.You really want a life change?
你真的想要你生命改变吗
？You don't know why you're so empty, always sad, always depressed, even though you have stuff. You don't know why.
如果你不知道为什么我拥有所有，但是我里面还是很空虚、
很寂寞。Then you wanna know, you wanna meet God, understand?
那你需要真的遇见神。
Then you really wanna meet God.
你真的需要遇见神。
Okay. And there is all your victory. I'm telling you, that's how I experienced it.
而在神里面，你有所有的胜利。
And I know, but man's mind is always on the useless things. You know?
我也知道人的思想总是在些无用的东西
上面。Don't seek the creation, seek the
creator. 不要去寻找被造的东西。
In him is all.
不要寻找被造的东西，要去寻找创造的那个人，那个神。
And in him is everything.
因为在他的里面，什么都是他的。
Okay, and even eternal life and heaven, dude, this is just garbage what you're looking at.
所以，相对于永生和天堂，我们现在所拥有的都是像垃圾一样。
When you see meet the truth, it will set you free.
你认识真理，真理能够释放你的自由。
Amen. Let's pray.
我们一起来祷告。
Father God, I've given them your word, Lord.
亲爱的巴父，感谢你，我将你的话语给他们。
Father God, we really need to and want to connect with you, Lord.
主要我们真的渴望与你相连。
But we know, Father, I know that we are weak.
我们知道我们是软弱的。
Our flesh is driving our minds to love the flesh.
我们的肉体一直在拖着我们的思想去爱这个肉体上的东西。
Father, I ask you, please cause something in our hearts, Lord.
主要真的是你来在我们心中动工。
To really be hungry for you.
让我们可以真的对你有渴慕的心。
And to really seek you, Lord.
真的去寻求你。
As you led me, Lord.
就像你带领我一样。
I ask you to please lead all of us to really seek you.
请你带领这边所有的人去认识神。
Only you can do it, Father.
只有你可以做到。
We're willing, Lord. We want to really meet and be changed.
我们愿意，我们愿意被改变，愿意被你遇见你。
From being valueless, we want to be valuable.
从无价值的，我们想要变得有价值。
And with you, we want to really have you in our lives.
我们也真的渴望有你在我们的生命当中。
Not just as a helper.
不仅只是来帮助我们。
But as a friend.
也是我们的朋友。
And as a lover.
是我们的爱人。
As our father.
我们的父亲。
As somebody we have real.Love relationship with.
和我们建立一个真实的爱的关系。
Father, help us all.
求你来帮助我们。
To really come and to know you.
能更多来认识你。
And help us give it up all this worldly.